We will start our today's class. So we completed the third lesson fully. So today we move to the book bag exercise revision. Okay. So listen to the class carefully and try to learn by the revision time itself. So within very soon you will get a summative exam. So try to learn through the revision. Okay. Okay. We will move to the class. So lesson name is First Aid. First one, we are seeing about filling the blanks. We should put out a fire caused by petrol by pouring dash over it. We should put out a fire caused by petrol by pouring dash over it. So do you all remember for petrol? Fire catched by petrol or kerosene, we should not pour water because petrol weight will be very lighter than the water, so it will be float on the water and the fire will extend more, the fire will spread. So for that we should use sand. So answer is sand. Second, if a dog bite is not treated, it causes a disease called dash. If a dog bite is not treated, it causes a disease called rabies. Third one, swelling caused due to dash bite can be reduced by applying baking soda. Swelling caused due to insect bite can be reduced by applying baking soda. Fourth one, a dash is tied above, below, and at the level of the fracture to support the broken bone. A dash is tied above, below, and at the level of the fracture to support the broken bone. Answer, splint. Do you all remember the picture what I showed? Splint is different and sling is different, isn't it? Splint means it's a supportive thing which we can wear it on the fractured area just like a pouch. But sling, it's a supportive thing. If any people get fracture on their arms, they need one support to make the arm to stand. For that, we use sling. Okay. Again, all the four, fill in the blanks. First one, we should put out a fire caused by petrol by pouring dash over it, by pouring sand over it. S-A-N-D, sand. Second, if a dog bite is not treated, it causes a disease called dash. If a dog bite is not treated, it causes a disease called rabies. R-A-B-I-E-S. Rabies. Third one, swelling caused due to dash bites can be reduced by applying baking soda. Swelling caused due to insect bite. I-N-S-E-C-T. Try to learn with the spelling. Insect bites can be reduced by applying baking soda. Fourth one, a dash is tied above, below, and at the level of the fracture to support the broken bone. Answer, splint. S-P-L-I-N-T. Splint. A splint is tied above, below, and at the level of the fracture to support the broken bone. Are you clear? One more time, shall we go through? Let's try to answer without seeing. We should put out a fire caused by petrol by pouring dash over it. Answer, sand. Second, If a dog bite is not treated, it causes a disease called dash. Answer, rabies. Third one, swelling caused due to dash bites can be reduced by applying baking soda. Answer, insect. Fourth one, a dash is tied above, below, and at the level of the fracture to support the broken bone. Answer, splint. Hope you're clear. We move to the next one. Okay. Next is the short answer questions. First one, what first aid is given in case of a chemical burn? Do you all remember what I thought on the day for chemical burn? It's very simple and easy. See the first point, remove any clothing present on the affected area. First, what we have to do, you can write by your own also. Okay, first understand the theme. Remove any clothing present on the affected area. So which part is affected? You doesn't know, you can't say. So that part, you should remove the cloth very slowly. Second, wash the chemical from the burnt area by placing it under cool running water for how many minutes? For at least 10 minutes. Understand? First point, you should remove the cloth from the affected area. That also should be very slowly and carefully. And second, you have to remove the chemical on that burnt area. So for how we can remove the chemical? By showing that particular part on the cool running water slowly for 10 minutes, you can show like that. Third point, burnt area should be covered with a loose sterilized gauze or a clean cloth. So before that, you can apply an antiseptic cream. Then you can cover the area with a sterilized gauze cloth or small bandage, a small clean cloth or kerchief, anything you can use. That also you should not tie it very tightly. It should be very loose. Understand? So what are the 3 points? First one, remove any clothing present on the affected area. Next, wash the chemical on the burnt area by showing the particular part on the cool running water for at least 10 minutes. Then you should apply an antiseptic cream. Then cover the burnt area with a clean cloth. Understand? So these are the first aid measures what we can given for chemical burns. Second, name 3 things that can cause burns. So for burns, I wrote on the board so many things. So here they in the question, they asked only 3. You can write any 3. Safa, the exam details and timetable, everything will be reach here. All the students through email or through the Google Classroom. Don't worry. Okay, check out. Burns can be caused by open flames, hot pans, and steam. Okay, what is the second question? Name 3 things that can cause burns. So burns can be caused by open flames, hot pans, and steam. You can write any 3, your wish. So okay, 1 and 2 together. What first aid is given in case of a chemical burn? In case of a chemical burn, remove any clothing from the affected area. Second, wash the chemical from the burnt area by placing it under cool running water for at least 10 minutes. And then you should apply an antiseptic cream. Then cover that burnt area with a sterilized gauze cloth or clean cloth. It should be very loosely, have to tie it. Second question, name 3 things that can cause Burns can be caused by open flames, hot pans, and steam. We move to the third one. How is tetanus caused? Nothing, Meha, just listen the class now. How is tetanus caused? Tetanus is a dangerous disease caused when a wound is caused by a dirty or rusted objects. Just listen the class, no need to think of anything, no timetable, nothing, just listen. What is, do you all remember about the tetanus? It's a disease, I told you. If we get any cut or scratch with the dirty things or with the rusted object, if we didn't put that anti-tetanus injection, people may fall under tetanus disease. Okay, so what is meant by rusted object? Rusted object means a thing which becomes old, like all metal item. Nails, screws, anything which becomes old. So that is called the rusted object. It leads to, if any people get cut or wound with that, we didn't give a proper treatment, it leads to tetanus disease. So how is tetanus caused? Tetanus is a dangerous disease caused when a wound is caused by a dirty or rusted objects. Okay, how is tetanus caused? Tetanus is a dangerous disease caused when a wound is caused by a dirty or rusted object. Fourth one. What is a sprain? Do you all remember I told you about the sprain? Sprain means in Tamil we say suluku. A sprain is an injury of the tissues around a joint such as ankle or wrist. Mostly sprain will happen on all joints. Here they have given two examples like ankle and wrist. You all know which is the ankle part. You all know which is the wrist part. So what is a sprain? A sprain is an injury of the tissues around a joint such as ankle or wrist. So what, Jivisha? It's a question. Name three things that can cause burns. You have to write only the name of the three things is enough. Why you are worrying about it is too small. Leave it, Jivisha. Okay, third and fourth, one more time. How is tetanus caused? Tetanus is a dangerous disease caused when a wound is caused by a dirty or rusted objects. Tetanus is a dangerous disease caused when a wound is caused by a dirty or rusted objects. Fourth one, what is a sprain? A sprain is an injury of the tissues around a joint such as the ankle or wrist. A sprain is an injury of the tissues around the joint such as the ankle or wrist. Hope you're clear. Shall we move to the next one? Only four short answer. One more time. What first aid is given in case of a chemical burn? So first one, remove any clothing present on the affected area. Wash the chemical from the burnt area by showing the part on cool running water for at least 10 minutes. Then apply an antiseptic cream. After that, cover the burnt area with a clean cloth. Or you can write sterilized gauze. Anything you can write. Okay. What first aid is given in a chemical burn? Try to answer without seeing. Remove any clothing present on the affected area. Wash the chemical from the burnt area by showing the part on cool running water for at least 10 minutes. Apply an antiseptic cream and you have to cover the burnt area with a sterilized gauze cloth or clean cloth. Second, name three things that can cause burns. Burns can be caused by open flames, hot pans, and steam. Burns can be caused by open flames, hot pans, and steam. Third one, how is tetanus caused? Tetanus is a dangerous disease caused when a wound is caused by a dirty or rusted objects. Tetanus is a dangerous disease caused by a wound. That wound also may be caused by dirty or rusted object. If we didn't give proper treatment, the person may lead to tetanus disease. It's a dangerous disease. Next, what is a sprain? A sprain is an injury of the tissues around a joint, such as the ankle or wrist. Okay, what is a sprain? A sprain is an injury of the tissues around a joint, such as ankle or wrist. Hope you are clear about the short answer. Shall we move to the long answer? Okay. See the long answer first one. How will you help a person who has sprained his or her joints? So what does the question mean? That is, they're asking the first aid measures for sprain. So just now we learned what is a sprain. A sprain is an injury of the tissues around the joint, such as ankle or wrist. So in this question, they are asking we have to write the first aid measures for the sprain. Okay, check out the answer. In the following ways, we can help a person who has sprained. First one, use an ice pack to bring down the swelling. So either you can use ice pack if you have, unless you can use ice cubes. Second, tie a crepe bandage at the joint for support to limit movement. Because sprain part will be very painful and become swell. You cannot move the part easily. So to avoid that, we can tie that particular part with a crepe bandage that is brown color for the limit movement. Next, let the person rest. While lying down, keep the sprained part at a height such that it is raised above the level of the heart. Why we need to make the thing to be high, just raised above the level of the heart? Because then only there will be a blood circulation freely. From top to bottom, there will be a blood circulation. It reached the heart. So only they are telling to keep that particular part just above the level of the heart. Understand? So again, how will you help a person who has sprained? First point, use an ice pack to bring down the swelling. Use an ice pack to bring down the swelling. Second, tie a crepe bandage at the joint for support to limit movement. So if that is any sprain, we cannot move that part. But if you want to move it, for example, if we have a sprain on the legs, without movement of the legs, we can't do anything. So for that movement, if you want to do, we can tie with a crepe bandage, which looks like a support. So by that support, we can move that particular part lightly. Next, let the person rest. No problem, Annie. One more time, I will teach. Do the revision, don't worry. So let the person rest while lying down. Keep the sprained part at a height such that it is raised above the level of the heart. Understand? So first point, you should use an ice pack to reduce the swelling. Second point, tie a crepe bandage which looks like a support. It makes that particular part for the limit movement. And third, the person should take rest and the sprained part should be just raised above the level of the heart. Okay, these three are the first aid measures should be given for the sprained. We move to the second one. What first aid measures should we follow if we get cut or scratched? Okay, first one. First aid measures we should follow if we get cut or scratched are: wash our hands first, as dirty hands cause an infection. So first point is for the first aid people who are going to giving. So those people should wash their hands thoroughly, because if any dirt in their hand, by that also infection may lead to that cutted part. So we have to, who is giving first aid, they should wash their hands thoroughly. Second, area around the wound should be washed to clear all the dirt. Understand? So which part you got cut or scratched, we should wash that area around that area. Next, affected area must be cleaned with an antiseptic lotion or antiseptic cream. Next, a thick pad of cotton wool or sterilized gauze must be placed on the wound and pressed tightly. Why they want to do like that? If they, after applying an antiseptic cream, if they tie the part with the sterilized gauze cloth, means they can control the bleeding. So that only they are doing. Next, a bandage can also be tied tightly over the wound to stop the bleeding. So after tying the gauze cloth also, there will be a bleeding. You can tie with a bandage tightly. After that also, if there is a bleeding, better the person should reach to doctor. Next, we should take an anti-tetanus injection. Do you know why? Because anti-tetanus injection can protect the person from the tetanus disease. So they have to take anti-tetanus injection. Understand? So what are the first aid measures should we give for the cut or scratched? First aid, the people who is going to giving a first aid, they should wash their hands thoroughly. Second, area around the wound should be washed to clear all the dirt. Next, they should apply an antiseptic lotion or cream. Then they should tie that area with a sterilized gauze to control the bleeding. Next, after that also, the bleeding is not stopped, they have to tie it with a bandage. And finally, they have to take anti-tetanus injection, which protect the people from the tetanus disease. Okay, these first aid measures and all you can write by your own. No need to by got everything and to write. Understand? So one and two together, What are the first aid measures can be given for a sprained person? So for the sprained person, first thing you should use an ice pack to bring down the swelling, or ice cubes also we can use. Second, tie a crepe bandage. Why we need to tie with the crepe bandage? Because the sprained part become very painful, we cannot move. If you get a hurt on the leg, if you want to walk, means what you will do if it is severe pain? So for to support, if you tie with the crepe bandage, it gives like a support, so you can slightly move that particular part. So that only we are giving a support by tying a crepe bandage. Next, swelling means in Tamil vingi porathu. Let the person rest. The particular sprained part should keep little height. It should be raised above the level of the heart. Then only there will be a blood circulation. Okay. So see the second one. This is the first aid measures we can give for cut or scratched part. First one, the first aid. Who is giving first aid? They should wash their hands thoroughly to remove the dirt. And next, for the injured person. Now it is for the injured person. We have to, that cutted part around the cutted area, they should wash thoroughly to remove the dirt, because through the cut the germs will easily enter into it and it leads to infection. So we should not allow like that. Next, we should apply antiseptic cream or lotion on the cutted area. Then you can tie the thing with that infected part with the cotton wool or sterilized gauze. Sterilized gauze means in hospital and all, you can see if any person got hurt, they will tie with white cloth. It's just like a thread like cloth, very transparent, that is called gauze cloth. So you have to tie it with that to stop the bleeding. If there is a continuous bleeding, we can use a bandage. And finally, we have to take anti-tetanus injection. Understand? So one more time, the short answer. First one, what first aid is given in case of a chemical burn? Remove any clothing present on the affected area. Wash the chemical from the burnt area by placing it under cool running water for at least 10 minutes. Then burnt area should be covered with the sterilized gauze or clean cloth. We should not tie it tightly, we have to tie it loosely. Second, name three things that can cause burns. Burns can be caused by open flames, hot pans and steam. You can write any three also other than this. How is tetanus caused? Tetanus is a dangerous disease caused when a wound is caused by dirty or rusted object. So if there is a wound caused by dirt or rusted object, if you didn't treat properly, it leads to tetanus disease. Next one, what is a sprain? A sprain is an injury of the tissues around a joint such as ankle or wrist. Sprain may happen near the joint area, the tissues. Here they're given only two examples, like ankles or wrists. Don't think only on the ankle and wrist sprain may happen. It may happen on anywhere, neck, shoulder, all jointed area tissues, sprain may happen. Okay, what is a sprain? A sprain is an injury of the tissues around a joint such as ankle or wrist. Understand? So today we saw the revision of fill in the blanks, short answer for questions, and long answer 1 and 2. So remaining long answer totally six long answer. 1 and 2 we finished, remaining 4 long answer we will check it out with the next class.